Good evening. I'm Kill the Vid, your host for the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And I'm back again with another edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate. This is going to be Gaming Livestream Walkthrough Episode 17. I'm about 63% into the main story missions of Assassin's Creed Syndicate. So, without any further ado, grab your favorite snack, your favorite drink, grab whatever you need. It's time for Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate, right now on the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Here we go. Okay, we have visual. So I am, of course, making headway in this game, and even after I'm finished with the main story, of course, I do have some DLC that I want to get into, especially Jack the Ripper, which takes place 20 years after the main story events of Assassin's Creed Syndicate. I'm excited to play that one. Anyway, let's go on with the main story. It continues. Hope everyone's having a good evening. Thanks for anyone that's been following me up this far. I'm trying to get to a partner with Twitch this year. So, hopefully, I'm pretty sure we can do it. For those who are not familiar with this version of Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Assassin's Creed Syndicate. It takes place in London in the year 1868. And you get to play as twin assassins, Jacob and Evie Fry. This is Evie Fry. In game, you can switch to Jacob, the male counterpart. And though these are twins, they have their skill sets different from each other, but they are both assassins nonetheless. And the most controversial thing about the Assassin's Creed Syndicate and the Assassin's Creed franchise is that it's the use of firearms, in addition to the use of the gauntlet with the concealed blade that retracts, slides in and out. Which anyone fans of the original series, which came out in 2008, come to know, and familiarize themselves with. So, you're in the town, of course, in London, England, in 1868. It's like the height of the Industrial Revolution. With that, there's innovation, and there's also, of course, corruption when it comes to industrialization. There's a storyline, of course, about the exploitation of workers at the expense of greed. And there's the main antagonist in Assassin's Creed Syndicate is Crawford Sterrick. He's got like a gangly eye. He's vindictive, ruthless, and all sorts of mean.
What you playing at, miss?
Mind your business, kid.
What's she up to? This person has just been murdered.
Yeah. Oh. And you run with a gang called the Rooks, while your rival gang is called the Blighters, and they're dressed in red, while the Rooks are typically dressed in green. And you can actually give them gang command. You can give them commands. You can get them to attack a certain somebody, which is optional. However, when it comes to the Blighters, they expect to fight with you right away. Cops are optional, except for like when you decide to voluntarily take them out, or they take you, or they try to do you in. Did they see you? Or they witness you doing activity? nefarious activity. Now, when it comes to the story missions, they are separated by the twins. They're going to be specific, where if you're doing a certain mission, it's going to call for Evie, while the other missions are going to call for Jacob. And it takes place, there's about 8 boroughs in London, England. Westminster, the Thames, and that's how it's pronounced, not the Thames, it's the Thames. Because I've also played Watch Dogs Legion, which is from Ubisoft, the same game manufacturer and developer. Because they publish and they develop their own games. That's what Ubisoft does. So, you know, when you've liberated a borough is when the section goes from red to clear, like you see. So now, we're doing sequence number 7. There's 2 more sequences left in the main story. This one's called Motion to Impeach. So, when you see this skull icon on the map, on the legend, on the map, it indicates a mission for Jacob, because Jacob is the one who does the killing. Wow. Evie does the investigation. Does the investigations. While Jacob is the flat out more hands-on, more brutal type assassin, but both of the twins are equally brutal. One uses tack while one uses brawn. When you boil it down to. But there's also, you can fast travel, which saves me the trouble of having to travel by foot or by carriage. Now, originally I got Assassin's Creed Syndicate for free because they had a special promotion where you can download the game. Unlike free, even though I do pay for games. Unlike some of you out there. And the crazy, weirdest thing I had just found out is that the Sony network, right? If you own the Sony PlayStation, no matter what you got, the 4 or the 5 or whatever, well, they made it so that certain games are not yours even though you paid money for them, even if you paid full price for them, and that they end up having to take them back because, from what I heard, according to a YouTube short, is that they don't want to pay royalties just to have for people to play those games even though they paid money for them. So it's kind of odd that a billion-dollar, multi-billion-dollar company brand doesn't want to pay out royalties, yet I would like to think that they make money hand over fist with billions of dollars, because the gaming industry is a multi-billion-dollar industry, where Hollywood, which has been around for like the past century or so, the industry, it's nowhere near when it comes to the game industry, too. Even though there are different types of mediums. But it's kind of peculiar that Sony wants to dial back on something like that. So if you do own physical copies of games, they are actually yours. Regardless, what if you downloaded them legally or not? quite stupid. I'm sure most of you will agree with that. Geronimo!
Why not?
So when I go right to this check, when I go to this waypoint, I'm automatically gonna switch to what's his face? I'm gonna switch to Jacob the moment I meet the waypoint.
Well, that may be true. I don't deny that you're all stout men of firm resolve who fully intend to stand your ground.
Short woman Otley.
But don't you think...
All stout women up to. I like imitating the British accent.
Nothing but the highest quality goods.
Sorry, I'll come back later. I'm already
full. I'm sorry there's nothing to your like.
Don't worry, I'll be back. I felt kind of guilty not buying anything. Because all I need to buy, I'm already topped up. I'm already ready to go. So when I switch to, when I do a mission, I switch the game mode so you can see the full cutscene. So I gotta go up top. So the sequence is called Motion to Impeach. So it's something political or political commentary oriented. So it's about, it has to do with preventing an assassination, even though I'm an assassin. It's ironic that you're an assassin trying to prevent an assassination. But yet you do certain assassinations as these characters or any characters in the Assassin's Creed franchise. But the parkour system is, I'd say, surprisingly unmatched. And mind you, this is the second Assassin's Creed game I've ever played, but I've never even completed the first one, even though I played it like over 15 years ago, like 2008. Right now it's 2024. Sequence 7, Motion to Impeach. Jacob plans to assassinate the Earl of Cardigan within the Houses of Parliament. So, it's to assassinate the Earl of Cardigan. Now, you just notice that Evie has a special cloaking ability that allows her to hide in plain sight. It's almost like AR cloaking, like in Assassin's Creed, not Assassin's Creed, but, Watch Dogs Legion, where you have an AR cloaking device that allows you. That allows your character to actually hide temporarily. So, the reward is 3,480 pounds, 4,000 XP, and the outfit that I unlock after completing the mission is the Blackguard suit, which is probably for, yes, probably for both characters. Anyway, I'm about to switch to Jacob.
What's this nonsense about needing a password to see Lord Cardigan today?
Relax. I've got it in my pocket.
Look sharp, men. Allow no one past unless I authorize them.
Cardigan has gone too far this time. I've a mind to contact Scotland Yard myself.
Come now, gentlemen. I thought us united in opposition against this perfidious law.
So that's the target right there, the mark. And he's got Templar support too. Which can't be good. Assassinate Lord Cardigan. Explore the area. Identify opportunities. Minister, unique kill opportunity. Corrupt policeman, stealth opportunity. Politician, assistance opportunity. So, here's certain criterias. If I can, optional criterias. First, you find the Earl of Cardigan. Criteria 1. Optional criteria number 1. Don't kill any policemen. And 2. Don't get detected. Don't get detected. By the target, of course. So let's do some. So. Let's examine. First, we're going to get over here. So I got the ego vision plus the identifier. First we need to get to the almost feel like Spider-Man or Batman even. So this is the politician. Let's speak with him. Locates target. Follow him to Lord Cardigan's office. So that's one. But first we want, the first thing we want to do is get the, take care of the corrupt cop. Kidnap him. So, well, first thing to do is we're going to speak with a politician. But then, brand ID on the target. Advantage unlocks unique kill. Steal Lord Cardigan's password. Steal Lord Cardigan's password. Anyway, let's start with the politician first. Who strongly opposes Lord of Cardigan. Out one of the guards. Oh wait, need to get a little closer. Look about his hair. It's a female one. Good divide and conquer. Oh shit, somebody's fucking. Where? All right.
believe that by any one expedient, and there is only one expedient in this bill, we can hope to put down corrupt practices. If the House is in earnest in its desire to put down corrupt electoral practices, and I am bound to believe it is, however,
are you?
Scandalous. Open.
Pardon me, gentlemen. Sergeant Freddy Abeline of Scotland Yard. Where might this scandalous activity be taking place?
There must be some expert. Did she stutter? Perhaps he was speaking.
Oh, yes, yes. It's just this way. Follow me, Sergeant, but discreetly, if you would. One doesn't like to be seen airing a fellow member of Parliament's dirty linen.
What?
In reality, only one thing. That thing is a vigorous one, and shows an adequate sense.
I'll be very discreet.
It shows a sense that in order to put down this great.
Usually I would be in disguise, but my clothes all fell into the Thames.
Took a wrong turn somewhere, boy. Hasty! Blimey! Oh, blimey! Oh, buddy!
Don't be alarmed. Let's go.
Dear Lord!
Okay, you may continue.
I beg you!
I'm a good man! I bloody swear!
All right. Shall we
Don't
go?
Kill me, please. I'm
Shall
bloody
we go?
Desperate.
Shall we go?
Please. I got a wife at home. Don't widow her.
Divide and conquer. Good strategy.
They call me a fanatic, a madman. I'll tell you what I'm fanatical about.
No, don't do that, please. I beg you.
Let me live. I've got an old mother needs taking care of.
Damn.
I surrender!
Please help me. Oh God, please save me!
Yep, and he just kills over and drops like a fly. Pet him. Let's help the guy up. Over here?
I have him!
Take that, suckers. Action. Don't mind the bodies. Don't mind the bodies. They had it coming. Shall we go, sir? No problem. In you go.
Supporters are rallying in the wake
password.
I beg your pardon. Propose the bill at this stage.
No password, no passage.
Shame.
Do you know who I am?
Where would we have been
I'm
in
a member of Parliament.
Should we have turned our coats at the first sign of lined against the wall and shot?
No password,
and
no passage.
So.
Sir, Christ, not Balaclava again.
I'm sorry, my lord. The wind blows in Disraeli's direction. Good day.
Gentlemen!
Huh? He's here!
Thank you.
goofed. So let's try this again. Excuse me?
Outstanding sentinels of Britannia are not wavering in their duties,
The Israeli supporters are rallying in the wake of the assassination attempt you discovered. To oppose the bill at this stage would be folly.
Shame! Shame! Where would we have been at Balaclava if we had turned our...
Gotcha, motherfucker.
The hero of Balaclava should fall not on the gloried fields of Crimea, but to an assassin's blade in the very halls of power.
Are you finished yet?
Take your bow, knave, for you have managed what no Russian battery, what no Indian tiger could achieve. Claim your trophy, and may you choke on it.
Yes, but do tell me more about Balaclava.
Farewell. Farewell, dear Britannia. Your dawn shall be dimmer that the Earl of Cardigan sees it not. God save the Queen and the 11th Hussars.
What a prick.
Now we split.
I'm going to cut you in two.
You're not gonna do shit. Knock, knock.
Somebody.
new something you try.
You saw nothing, right?
Please, I don't want to die in a wretched place such as this.
Don't worry, you won't.
Where did he come from? I am your
liquor. I'll eat your eyes.
Sucker. Man, what goodies do you hide in there? Bye bye. Good boy. The house is the parliament. That's where I just was.
Get in the way, stack free.
I feel bad about running over the pedestrians on here. Especially ones who didn't deserve it. Much like in GTA, you run already, buddy. You pretty much don't give a damn. Do not get detected by target. Oh, wow. I still get the... break this memory, and I still get the blackguard suit, and I still get the money. Survival.
Slow down now.
Mush. Back to the 21st century.
Apart from the death squad on our tail, apart from that.
Backup's on the way. Why are you pushing yourself so hard? It's not your job to fight Templars.
I had this colleague. He was our boss's son. I didn't much care for him at the start. Everyone treated him like he was so bloody special. To me, he He just wasn't invested in anything that didn't affect him personally.
I just love watching these cutscenes.
But I was wrong about him. He became my friend, put himself through hell, and he saved us all in the end. So I reckon, well, I can't apologize to him, but I can try and live up to his example.
You are a good assassin.
Holy jeez!
Hello. It has been too long.
Galena! Blimey, I have not seen you since we blew up that lab in Paris.
Duh, there were many explosions and you screamed like a baby.
There's a delay in the dialogue.
Bishop tells me Otzoberg is here. I will kill him for you.
Super. Great news. Now, if you wouldn't mind keeping watch, I am going to lie down and die now.
Rest. We have a big fight coming.
Sean and Rebecca are safe for now, but we're still relying on you to find us that shroud.
Uh-oh. Crawley and Crawford staring again.
Order has bred disorder. The sea rises to flood the pubs and extinguish the street lamps. Our city will die.
Nope.
Tupine has failed. Lucy has failed. Brudenell, Elliotson. Pearl. All have gone into the night. It is up to me now. The assassins have brought nature's fury into our homes. Men have become monsters, barreling toward us, teeth out. Our civilization must survive this onslaught. To prevent a return of the Dark Ages, I will start anew. London must be reborn.
The Peace of Eden is under Buckingham Palace. We've got all we need. Let's start planning our infiltration.
Hold on. Better to get visual verification. If we're gonna move, we need to be 100% sure. We'll only get one shot before Otso Berg crashes down on us.
Gotta agree with Sean.
We'll position ourselves near the palace. But we'll wait for you to sync the genetic data before we move.
It's all up to you, Initiate.
I'm the Initiate. I'd like to take this time to say, if you are enjoying the stream and if you like the content I'm bringing you, why not consider following and subscribing to the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, as I'll be producing future live streams, such as for games as Assassin's Creed Syndicate, Mad Max, Sleeping Dogs, and many others. And if you'd like to contribute to the Outlaw, I do have a Patreon listed in the description. You can contribute if you like. I would greatly appreciate that as well. And now, on with the stream.
You're late. Starrick is making his move. The Peace of Eden is somewhere inside Buckingham Palace.
Let him have it.
I've seen your handiwork across the city. Perhaps you should trust my judgment.
I've been killing Starrick's henchmen. What have you been doing? Let's ask Henry, shall we?
I have been repairing your mistakes. Too much haste is too little speed.
So, the sister and brother are clashing with each other.
And I am sorry, this doesn't involve anything you
can destroy. Your
father was right, he never approved of your methods.
And methods.
Father is dead!
Enough! I have just received word from my spies. At the palace ball tonight, Starrick plans to steal the Peace of Eden, and then eliminate all the heads of church and state.
Oh god.
Once more for old time's sake.
And then we're finished.
Agreed. So what's the plan?
Such an unexpected delight to visit you both. What is the news on the street?
Mrs. Disraeli, we have discovered that there is something inside Buckingham Palace that could threaten the...
What my sister's failing to say is that we require entrance into the ball tonight.
Impossible! Even if there were any invitation cards remaining, which there are not, someone of your lowly station...
If that damn fool Gladstone is attending this evening, they can have my card.
Perfect. Then I'll go alone.
Mrs. Disraeli, if you would be kind enough to inform my darling brother of the location of the Gladstone's residence, perhaps he could use his considerable skills to commandeer their cards.
What fun! Did you hear that, Dizzy? We're going to pinch the Gladstone's invitations.
Thank you for volunteering me, sweet sister.
Oh, a pleasure, brother, dearest. Now, Mrs. Disraeli, if you would excuse me, I must visit with the Maharaja. It occurs to me that he may have a second set of plans to a certain vault.
reach the Gladstone's house, but don't kill any policemen.
Treating me like a child.
Let's check on the safe. The lag. Not full, but it's okay. Now let's check on the inventory. Black guard suit, Maximum Dracula, Suave suit. Inward. Upgraded. Check the bit. The mother of all guns, I think. Got some helix points worth using. Oh wait, I don't have enough, never mind. Let's check on the map. Okay. So we break into the Gladstones residence and steal those invitation cards. And the Oh, I didn't top up my weapons and supply. I'll just go to a shop. Take that, sucker. I'm trying to fast travel, but doesn't seem to be anywhere close to it. Wish they had a first person. I'm going in Godfather style. Thank you.
covered!
And there's a shop right there.
Everything you need to support. Thanks for your business.
Don't kill any policemen.
Now, where can they be?
The ball is tonight. They must have taken the invitations with them. You wouldn't happen to have seen two carriages pass by here just now?
I did, sir. One with a man in it, the other with a woman. They split up.
Where did the man go?
That way.
Thank you. Walk on, girl. Let's go. They went in this direction.
Easy! Slow! Slow!
That's a girl. Steady on. I'm on the right track. Doing fine, girl. Who's a good horse?
Okay. You are approaching the location. Oh, wait. Everybody out. Follow me. I saw a chest in it. Must be upstairs. Still his invitation.
A private party event. Don't mind if I do.
stop him!
Looks like trouble.
Mitts on you, you'll wish you'd come quietly.
I'm gonna take this as fast as I can. Be right back.
Maybe I haven't been quite as delicate as
okay,
I could have
been. Back.
But still.
Follow me, troops.
Mrs. Gladstone's under guard. Better be cautious. Better wait until she's alone.
You, and when I do, you'll regret it.
Oh.
calm. Let's put an end to all this. Damn it! Better catch up! He's here! Stop!
That's funny. Your drop. Now hand it over. Hand it over. Now, lady, hand it over.
Someone must have fled Lambeth Asylum.
Hand it over, lady. Yoink!
One should not attend the Queen's ball without making a proper entrance.
Now we get to boost your cat, your cattage. But I need to top up on some supplies. Hey you, about to take this here carriage.
Now for the invitations. What's this? Swords must be left at the door by order of the Queen. Freddy will know what to do.
moving.
Whoa, now. Stop the shot.
Come again now.
Stink, ain't you? All right.
Walk on, girl.
That's the way.
Thank you. courage, Jackie. Get inside.
Doing fine, girl.
So much for trying to meet the criteria, the optional objective of not damaging the carriage. So much. So well. Who cares? Devil's handshake schematic must be a special gauntlet. Oh, we're already on sequence time. Piss off!
My God! Thank you! This restores some of my faith in humanity. My God! Thank you! This restores some of my faith in humanity.
Yes, brandishing a gun can get their points across. Dress to impress, Sequence 9. Jacob meets Aberline to discuss getting weapons into the vault. Okay. You.
Quite a carriage you got there. Where did you buy it, if you don't mind me asking?
Ask all you want, Freddy. You'll never get an answer.
Damn it all.
Was it my eyebrows?
Yes, and your face, voice, and body. Look, I've got an invitation to the Queen's ball tonight. How did you come by that? Freddy, there's to be an attack on the ball. I need to smuggle some weapons inside to prevent it.
Supposing I believe you, only the Royal Guard carries weapons.
So?
Too easy.
For God's sake, Freddy.
Fine. I require a guard's uniform.
Done. I knew you'd come through.
Just promise me, Jacob, that you will return Mr. Gladstone's coach.
Of course.
Reach St. Martin Church.
Thank you.
So it's the last hour of this. Knock out the Royal Guard, but don't kill anyone. So I can go in disguise.
Only cutthroats hide like that.
Here! Nick him!
Get him!
I see the little tyke!
Careful. Don't want to get blood on the uniform.
Look, oh yes, it's come out.
Careful. Don't want to get blood on the uniform.
Grab his arm!
Flash, motherfucker. Rob your week's pay. Give him a... reinforcements. Now come and catch me. I'm gonna kick your ass when I get my hands on you. Catch me.
He's there. You'll never get away from me.
Wanna bet? I'll see you up there. You can't have gone far. Stop.
He's there.
British Royal Guard.
Hey, don't move.
Keep watch.
Not your night. Give me a uniform. Give me your duds. I'll be taking your duds. Your royal duds.
Charming.
Now to hide the body.
Man, don't wake up. Yeah. I don't know. Where do we hide the body? Hide the body. Get it. Okay. Let's go find a cat. place is heavily guarded, so I gotta watch myself. Oh shit. Oh fuck, they spotted me.
Prepare for a volley!
Kick their asses!
There's a brave boy! Work together, lads!
Whoop his ass, thank you. Thank you. Don't wake up. Now give me your shit. Now run your shit.
What on earth is going on over there?
Now run your shit. Okay, the last half hour of this stream. You're in there. Hey, you got a body to get rid of. Can I use your carriage?
What's all the ruckus?
Oh, damn, can't use this one. It's got to be one of those open and closed ones, concealed ones. Hey, you. Go.
Freddy, here I come.
Now, let's go.
One uniform as requested.
It's still warm.
My gift to you?
I will meet you on the roof of Buckingham Palace.
You're such a romantic.
Master Assassin.
Thank you.
Family politics. That's why I get to switch as Eevee this time. So we're nearing the end here. Because we're on sequence 9. But there's also some additional DLC. First with Quick Drive.
Teach this clot a lesson.
Fuck these nuts. Surprise, motherfucker! Boogie boogie. Starry night, sucker. Evie visits Dulit Singh to learn if a second set of Buckingham plans exist. Okay. And then we'll end the stream upon completion if possible. Last 15 minutes of the screen.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. Acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be when one is so often underestimated.
Steal a carriage without entering the courtyard.
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake. anything I should know about?
If you really want me.
Last few minutes of the stream.
Come on.
We'll have to get ready to end the stream. About to end the stream in a few minutes.
Shall we lobby our cause, Miss Fries?
Climb up, Your Highness. Where are we headed?
Belgrave Square.
And that's going to do it for this edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate on the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Do me a favor, if you like the content I'm bringing you, consider following and subscribing to the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, as I'll be producing additional Let's Play gaming livestream walkthroughs in the future. Until then, I'm Killed a Vid with the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And please, stay safe.